was perfect.
There was also a cassette that Ethan had that had at least.
Yeah, it's funny. You know, I think about 25, sorry to jump in, but that's totally not true, everything you said. you're blurring two memories together into one memory, but that's okay.
Went out a lot, too.
It's all true, it just the timeline is different. So, there was a...
Yeah, tell them. We started shooting Houston. No. You sent the cassette with Stan.
Exactly, but I don't want to contradict Stacey, but the truth is that I heard the song. Lisa was in my theater company, and was a great friend and somebody I cared about a lot. And after we'd shot the film, I heard her play this song, and I'd spoken to Ben about the cut of the movies. Something happened, but I asked her, that song is so perfect for Reality Bites. Go home, and she went and recorded it on a 4-track, and I sent the cassette to you. And then the benefit was, the theater company didn't have a benefit until after Reality Bites came out, baby. So, I mean, those things, right. We made so much. Lisa playing Irving Plaza was what launched the theater company to a new level. So,
right. And also on that cassette, there were some other songs too, like Frank Whaley's band, right?
Yeah, a bunch of different songs.
What I remember about the Stay, first of all, Stacey and Michael really did have so much to do with creating the soundtrack album, which now, like, the soundtrack album entity, or the idea of a soundtrack album, doesn't even exist really anymore. But Stay was a negotiation, I remember, with the soundtrack company, because they, nobody knew who Lisa was, they didn't know it was going to be a huge hit. What's it?
She's the first unsigned. I don't know if I'm the first unsigned rock and roll artist to ever go to number one.
Yeah, baby.
And that record lasted until about 5 years ago when people were unsigned and putting their stuff on the internet. I think that the pop and tag song is what died.
But I remember negotiating.
Only one.
I remember you took us over to the office of the record company guy. And we had to negotiate what we'll get on the album or not, and it came down to, if you want to keep Stay on the album, then you can't have the Peter Frampton song, Baby I Love Your Way, unless you let Big Mountain, this reggae band, cover it.
No, you knew that was a devil's bargain.
No,
that
was a devil's
bargain. You had a line,
it's not when they,
that was a bad bargain. The Stay is fantastic. What did you lose that you wanted that Big Mountain was?
No, I just wanted to have the actual Peter Frampton song.
Yes,
they said have Big Mountain cover it, and then it became a big hit anyway.
It's still awesome.
It scarily went to number one, and we were like, it cannot be in the movie.
Yeah, they wouldn't let us put it on the soundtrack.
That Big Mountain, there's just no reason to make it a reggae.